Very good question. I think in the future we should all drive electric. And the main reason is that we got a big CO2 problem. We take oil out of the ground, burn it, and that will definitely take us back to the dinosaur age where we got too much CO2 in the air. So if we want to save the world, we have to drive electric. Because with electric, you can use any source of energy. You can use water energy, power energy, you can use windmills, you can use solar panels, and you even can use everything. Electric is the future. It's not that we have to go a step down, it's a step up. The driving behavior, you got a lot of torque, so it's very comfortable to drive. You don't have to shift. It's very compact. So it's the way for the future. The basic idea with this Carver concept is that we wanted to make a city vehicle which what price concern is between a scooter and a car. And because it's very aerodynamical, so we need not as much energy to propel it. So with a quite small battery pack, we can already achieve 2.5 hours of driving with this vehicle. And that's for one day more than enough for the use.
Of course, the batteries, for an electric vehicle, the batteries is the most expensive part of a vehicle. And to make it for large volumes, you need to bring the price down as much as possible. Okay. So that's why I think that electric vehicles should be very light, it should be very aerodynamical, because the batteries is the most expensive part of the vehicle. Almost everything is maintenance free, apart from the brakes. We brake with regen, so we use less brake pads wear, but eventually the brakes will wear down. And second, the tires, they wear down as quick as normal. So it's brakes and tires and all the other things are almost maintenance free. Well, you see more and more quick charging. To be honest, for normal vehicle, this is a city vehicle, this is a low speed, but for normal high speed vehicles, depends on how fast you can charge. Be flexible. I think you need both. You need the DC charge, fast charger, and the AC slow charger. For instance, at my house there is no charging station, so I have to do with AC charging. It's the other way around. The main reason why we see a lot of four-wheelers and wide four-wheelers is they don't use this tilting technology. With a Carver we have the possibility to make a very narrow vehicle. If you normally would make a four-wheel not tilting vehicle, if you take a corner too fast, you will flip over to the outside. Because of this invention which we use in the Carver, which is a fully automatic tilting system, it tilts like a motorbike, drive it like a car, and that makes a very stable concept, even when you make a corner fast. And that's why we can make a vehicle less than 1 meter. I will start with the advantage. Yeah. Personally, my biggest advantage is that it's so much fun to drive. But that was not the reason why we developed it. We developed it because we want to have an aerodynamical footprint of one person wide. We specifically developed this vehicle for one or two persons, but they are sitting behind each other. Mm. So that's a very less aerodynamical drag. But then I come to the disadvantage. If you are with four persons, you should take a normal car which is suitable for four persons. So if you drive alone or with two, you should take this kind of vehicle, but if you want to, yeah. Yes and no. What I just already explained, it's a city vehicle, which has got a top speed just below 50 kilometers an hour. So if you take a Carver, you already take something which is in reach. You can drive 2.5 hours with a Carver, and that's a long time. So you will not take a Carver if you want to go from here to Amsterdam, but you will take a Carver if you go from here to Rotterdam. Yes and no. It depends on what to which kind of vehicle you compare it with. If you're with four persons and you have one family, you got a budget of only buying one vehicle, and then people will buy a four persons vehicle. Specific our target group is people who are living alone or living with two and want to be more flexible. We see that a lot of people already have got a car and for holidays and for long distance and for the city they use the car. Yeah, well, it's not a car, it's not a motorbike. The safety, we have got a very safe rollover cage, which protects the persons, giving the maximum protection. Mm-hmm. You don't need to have a wear helmet, because all the safety belts have been tested. This is a 50 kilometers per hour vehicle. That's got a different kind of standard as if you compare it with a Mercedes high speed 200 kilometers an hour vehicle. So you have to see the perspective.
Yeah.
We used the wheel hub motor, which is inside the wheel. Here you can see this is the shaft which is on the suspension, and this can turn. And the rim is directly mounted on the motor. And we choose this kind of package because we wanted to place between the wheels our battery pack. Low center of gravity, and then the wheel motors. So we got two of these, one on the left and one on the right.